the 21st day of the month of September, in an early year of a decade not too long before our own, the human race suddenly encountered a deadly threat to its very existence. And this terrifying enemy surfaced, as such enemies often do, in the seemingly most innocent and unlikely of places.
Downtown, where the clubs are broke, we go downtown, where your life's a joke, you go downtown. ago.
Right.
this.
I'm afraid it isn't feeling very well today.
Yeah. Now, isn't that bizarre?
At least, what kind of weirdo plant is that, Seymour?
I don't know. It looks like some kind of flytrap, but I couldn't identify it in any of my books. So I gave it my own name. I call it an Audrey 2.
After me?
Oh, I hope you don't mind. You see, sir, if you put a strange and interesting plant like this here in the window, well, maybe.
Maybe what? You have any idea how ridiculous you sound? Just because you put a strange and interesting plant in the window, people don't suddenly come running.
Excuse me! I couldn't help noticing that strange and interesting plant. What is it?
It's an Audrey 2.
I have never seen anything like that before.
No one has. Where'd you get it? Well, you remember that total eclipse of the sun a couple of weeks ago? I was walking in the wholesale flower district that night. Mr. Mushnick and Audrey
Renee doesn't mention, but I've been going through this with you for weeks. Grow and wilt, spurt and flop. Are you sickly little plant or just plain stubborn? What is it you want? What is it you need? I've given you sunshine. I've given you dirt. You've given me nothing but heartache and hurt. I'm begging you sweetly. I'm down on my knees.
Picture!
Picture! Skid row! Skid row!
If I had a mother, she'd be so happy.
Born overnight sensation, Seymour. Who'd have believed it? One day he pushed a broom, not seen in his news, but blue man do. Then nearly defused and give him room. Stand aside and watch that love blow. Explosion, make her boom. Don't want it gonna show you nothing. Seymour was in a funk. He was number zero. Who'd have thunk? He'd become a hero, just a punk. He was a threat, so and so. Then one day,
crash kerplunk.
Lawn out front and the same Some roads are flocking and fences have been booming. We need refrigeration in our new improved display, so we're called for renovation today.
Yes, indeed, this is the shop you heard about on Channel 5 News. Yes, the object is on display exclusively here.
We're called for decoration. Construction has been smiling. Till now we're due for painting.
I slipped.
Date?
Your date?
Yeah. you ain't by any chance talking about a girl with a black eye, are you?
There's several other medical problems.
That is a matter of fact. Hey, please, I'm friendly. A truce. Potch him. Want some nitrous oxide?
Oh, why don't you get lost, Vitalis Brains? The last thing Audrey needs is more of your kind.
My kind?
Yeah.
It is a very nice kind. I'm not a monster.
What else would you call it?
I would call it... I would call it an occupational hazard.
Say what?
You see, girls, my line of work requires a certain fascination with human pain and suffering.
I'm not a jerk.
Oh! This stuff is great. I'll have you explain. When I was younger, just a bad little kid, my mama noticed funny things I did. I'd shoot the puppies with a BB gun. I'd poison guppies, and when I was done, I'd find a pussycat bash in its head. That's when my mama said.
What did she say?
She said, my boy, I think someday you'll find a way to make your natural tendencies pay.
Could be your ticket to the stars. You could take it to the florist shop in town and name your price.
Hell, somebody make a goddamn partner to get their hands on this!
Well, I don't care. I'm happy here.
Seymour's very loyal.
Somebody talking to you?
Oh, no. Excuse me.
Excuse me what?
Excuse me, doctor?
That's better. I'm telling you, kid, this thing's a big green gold mine. Get your ass out of this dump and take that plant with you. Mushnick Skid Row Forest. That's why that jump. You hear me talking?
I hear you.
We share them. Sorry, what?
I'm sorry, doctor.
You got a train of ace, Doug? Well, my mind's outside the double park. But you think about what I said, Scott. I mean, you think about it.
Sure, I'll think about it.
Think about it. You do that. Okay, Audrey. Got the handcuffs?
They're in my bag.
Then let's go. Bill, think about it. Bill, think about it.
I don't like that guy, Chewy. Did you hear the way he talked to Audrey?
Him will know the kid just said it falling over.
No wonder she looks so unhealthy. It's enough to make you sick.
If he left me, if Seymour left me, why then I'd be right back where I started. It was broken, starving.
Sweet and good and beautiful as she is, she deserves a prince, not a sadistic creep like him.
Close to bankrupt.
What a louse.
And be fuddled and bereft. That's where I'd be if Seymour left.
He's a disgrace to the dental profession.
Seymour!
Sir?
Seymour! How would you like to be my son? How would you like to be my own adopted boy? I never liked him much before, but count the cash and send the number. I've got no choice, I must deport.
Say yes!
What for?
Seymour, I want to be your dad. I want to see you climbing up my family tree. I used to think you left a stench, but now I see that you're a man, so I'm proposing to be my son.
Come move in with me.
You swear?
I promise.
What a son.
sun. I'm in sun. Sudden changes surround me. Lady Luck came and found me. Thanks a million for making the magic you do. Thanks to you, sweet Petunia. Mushnik's taking a junior. And someday, when I own this whole shop, I'll remember I owe it to you. Who cares if I've been a little on the anemic side these past few weeks? So what if I've had a little lightheadedness, a few dizzy spells? It's been worth it, old pal. Whoa, well, Dewey, I'm a little hungry. I'm gonna run down to Schmendrick's and get a bite to eat. But I'll see you when I get back, huh?
Come on, kid, what will it be? Money? Girl? One particular girl, how about that? Oh! Think it over. There must be some you can aim at six. We are quiet now. And get me some lunch! Think about a room with the Ritz. Whack things that'll be covered in blitz. A little nugget gonna clean up your seats. You get it? But it's true, isn't it?
No. I don't know anybody who deserves to be chopped up and fed to a hungry plant.
Sure you do.
The drill, Seymour!
It's rusty.
It's an antique. They don't make instruments like this anymore.
Sturdy.
This is gonna be a challenge. This is gonna be a pleasure. I'm gonna want some gas for this one.
Gas?
Nitrous oxide.
Oh, thank God. I thought you weren't gonna use any.
Gas isn't for you, Seymour. It's for me! I want to really enjoy this, and I find the little dim gas before we begin increases my pleasure enormously. In fact, I'm going to use my special gas mask. Just relax, Seymour. I'll be with you in a moment.
Do it now, while he's gassing himself to a palpable stupor. The timing's ideal and the moment is super. Ready and fire and blow the sick bastard away. Now, do it now. Just a flicker of pressure right here on the trigger, and Audrey won't have to put up with that creep for another day. Now, for the girl.
Thank you.
Can you
call back in the morning? Thank you.
Call back in the morning.
Oh, 1 minute, Audrey. I want to show you something.
Oh, can it wait till tomorrow?
All right, it won't take long. I've been shopping for a new wardrobe like you told me to, and, hey, what do you think?
Seymour!
Well, you don't like it?
I don't know!
Oh no! I'll take it off! I'll take it back! I'll burn it! Just, oh, don't cry, please! Oh. I only bought it to impress you. That's all I ever meant to do.
I don't know what's come over me. I guess I've been a little under the weather lately.
It's all right, isn't it? You've been down in the dumps ever since his mysterious disappearance. You miss him, don't you?
I miss him. Oh, I never felt so relieved as when they told me he vanished. It was like a miracle. And not to mention all the money I've saved on Epsom salts and his bandages.
Then what's the matter?
Well, I feel guilty, I guess. I mean, if he met with foul play or some terrible accident of some kind, well, then it's partly my fault, you see? Because secretly, I wished it.
Oh, Audrey, you shouldn't waste one more minute worrying about that creep. There's a lot of guys who'd give anything to go out with you. Nice guys.
Oh, I don't deserve a nice guy, Seymour.
Well, that's not true.
Oh, you don't know the half of it. I've led a terrible life.
Well, Audrey, don't.
I deserve to creep like Lawrence Crivello, DDS. You know where I met him? In the gutter.
The gutter?
The gutter. It's a night spot. I used to work there on my nights off when we weren't making much money. And I put on cheap and tasteless outfits, not nice ones like this. Oh, and the nasty apparel. And I...
Audrey, that's all behind you now. You don't have anything to be ashamed of. You're a very nice person, and I always knew you were. Underneath the bruises and the handcuffs, you know what I saw? A girl I respected. I still do. Lift up your head. Wash off your mascara. Give your mind Kleenex. Wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face. Clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly Seymour you. You don't need no makeup. Don't have to pretend. Suddenly Seymour is here to provide you sweet understanding.
Thank you.
Seems the plot is thickening among my employees.
Oh, please, Mr. Daddy.
Don't you Mr. Daddy me, Trellhorn. Audrey, I wondered if you'd excuse Seymour and me for a little while. Perhaps you'd like to go visit your dentist friend.
That's not very funny, Dad. You know he disappeared.
Oh, that's right. He did, didn't he? Forgive me, boy chick.
Seymour, what's he talking about? What's he doing?
Why don't you run along like he asked, Audrey? I'll catch up with you later. I'll call for you if that's all right.
Of course it is. Good night, Seymour. Good night, Mr. Mushnick.
Little red dots all over the floor.
You're acting pretty strange, Paul.
I had a pretty strange afternoon, son. After my lawyer's appointment, I was called to the police station.
The police?
Yes. Seems they made a routine investigation into the disappearance of this motorcycle dentist. And when they did, it seems they found the Mushnick Skid Row florist bag in his office.
Oh, what's that supposed to mean?
Exactly what I asked myself, Seymour. And then I began to think about certain things I've noticed around here lately. Little red dots all over the linoleum.
I spilled some Hawaiian punch and it stained.
Hard to keep things clean around here, isn't it? Especially when they only remove our garbage once a month.
What does that have to do with... where are you going?
If you want something removed in a hurry, it's best not to dispose of it on Skid Row.
What are you talking about?
This! A dentist uniform.
Miss, don't you know but now?
I saw it last week and didn't think twice.
Don't you know?
And the little red dots seemed innocent
you
enough.
Got no place to hide.
Then I catch you kissing the dentist's girlfriend.
Got nowhere to run.
And it begins to look like a motive.
He knows you love a crime.
Once he's out of the way, you move in, right?
I think it's supper time.
And asked if I could identify him.
Oh, did you?
No, they don't suspect you at all, Seymour. But they don't know about the dots, the uniform, the girlfriend.
No, I didn't do it.
Then come with me to the police and tell them that.
He's got his facts.
Just throw my conscience with my teeth.
You know he's on your way.
And then don't try to go tell him
I'm here.
Whoa, what the?
No.
Is it true Audrey 2 is grand marshal for the Rose Bowl?
Is it true the shop is decorating for the senior prom?
Yes, it's all true, now, please.
There's another big hot shop looking for you, Seymour, from uptown. It's been asking all over where can you find you. You're famous, Seymour.
Is that him?
That's you, Mr. Bernstein.
Thank you, girls. Seymour Crumb! Oh, sweetie, honey, babe, what's got?
Do I know you?
No, oh, of course not. Are you going to be happy with you doing that? Seymour, sweetheart, doll face, boo-boo-loo. Hey, Seymour Crumb, on your prince, you. My name is Bernstein, and I'm with NBC. I came down here to convince you in particular to do a weekly TV show for me. Oh, yeah? Check this out. Seymour Crowborn's got an in tips. For half an hour on Sundays at 4. Can you feel that? I can feel it. TV's first home got an in program. Here you go. You'll make a mint and our ratings will soar.
New success would come with messy, nasty screens. My
flourished as before. She might not like me. She might not want me. Without my plant, she might not love me anymore.
Happily ever after. I promise. Nice little house.
beautiful car. And no planes, no planes at all.
You're talking so peculiar, Seymour.
I'll explain everything to you tomorrow. Just go home now, Audrey, please.
I can't leave you in this condition.
Don't worry about me. Don't worry about anything.
Thank you.
place, Mrs. Martin's right over there.
Thanks, sweetheart. Wait for me. Crowborn? Seymour Crowborn?
Leave me alone.
Patricia Martin, Marketing and Licensing Division, World Botanical Enterprises. I've got a gilt-edged proposition for you.
I'm not interested.
Well, then let me explain in more detail. We take leaf cuttings, develop little laundry tubes, and sell them to florists across the nation. Pretty soon, every household in America will have one. Imagine Audrey tubes everywhere. What? With the right advertising, this could be bigger than hula hoops.
Bigger than hula hoops.
Much bigger.
Every household in America, thousands of you eating. This is what you've had in mind all along, isn't it?
No shit, Sherlock.
Open the bed!